Timing chain installation pack. Okay, and this our job starts in this crank this area, crankcase area, and crankshaft. This area is in here, and this is our first thing what we need to check, because there are those two of those metallic pins in here, and we have to set up these pins in just in this direction. And let's go to look closer. And this is like that area where are those two black pins, and these pins are important when we install this smaller timing chain in here. And it is good that I a little bit move my this flywheel. Look, this moves a little bit move in this direction. Now this is fine, excellent. And then we go to look in this oil pump area. And in here oil pump area we can see in very small dent in that bolt in here. And let's go to look that area also. We can see that in this up area there is very small dent, and this dent must be in up, not in that way, just in here, this small dent, that there is this blade. Okay, good. Now I have adjusted, and then I need to take those wheels. Now when these two crankshaft, these locking pins are in here, in that side, and then this oil pump, these central bolts, this dent plane is up, then I can take those wheels. Again, there is this my oil pump timing chain, and note that now this upper sprocket, it goes in that way in here, in centrally in here. And there is small dot in here, and dot must be in up, good. And then this next oil pump wheel, now we can see this dent in their inner area. This goes of course in that way. That way, in this way, good. And here I have then this small oil pump timing chain. And then these markings, yellow area, it must match in this up area. In that way. Now there's small dot in here. See the small dot and then yellow line. These are in line. In here this down area. I have to adjust this my chain so that there is this tensioner. I a little bit move the tensioner in here, in that way, good. And then I can install this my, I install tensioner and then this my wheel and chain. They are same line, and now when I install this my chain, there is also small dot in that wheel. And this small dot, it must fit in this yellow line. Now I install the yellow line in here. And then this all parts fit nicely. And then I check also that this those planes are okay, everything looks fine. Excellent. And now this my chain is in position, and also dents, yellow dents are in line, and in here everything looks good. We can see there also the small dent in here, and yellow line, everything is fine, good. And then we need this nut in here, and this nut in that area, and let's go to install that nut. Okay, and then I need something, a small tool, like this screwdriver, what goes directly in that hole in here. This is like locking position. Because next I need to lock this my, like this sprocket, because I install in here nut. My screwdriver is in position, and then I can take my nut in here. Okay, and here is this my nut. And now I rotate that in here inner. Firstly in my fingers. And then I need Togue torch French tool and 14 1/4 millimeter socket what fits in here, and then this Togue force is 30 newton meters. Okay, and then I can do this my tight process, and now I need a little bit longer bar, because this must go in this direction. Now I have a little bit longer bar and 14 millimeter socket, and this is like in lock pin in here, and then I use my Togue torch French tool, and when there is sound, force is okay. Okay, good. Now there is 30 newton meters force in that nut. Now 30 newton meters force has installed this oil pump back in here, and then I need to check that this my all sprocket positions are fine. Everything looks good, tensioner works well, everything is good, and we can go forward. And then I need to install this upper timing belt, and that's I need to rotate this my crankshaft so that these metallic pins are in up. And now I rotate carefully my flywheel. Okay, and now they are in central position, and then I can take this timing chain crankshaft sprocket, and there are those dents, and it is easy to install, and it goes in that way, not in this way, note that. And in this way, now it's good. And then I have in here this chain damper, vibration damper, and two of these 10 millimeter bolts. And I install bolt in, there is first bolt, and then we have here the second bolt, and then I can use carefully this 10 millimeter socket. Good, and then I use my Togue friends in these areas. Okay, and then I need my Togue torch friends tool, and force is now 10 newton meters. This force what I need to use, and there is this my socket, and I fasten these two bolts. Good, it is ready, and then upper one. Okay, good, and both of those, they are fine, excellent. And now this chain vibration damper is in position. Good. Then I have to set up these camshafts timing marks in right in here, and let's go to look those things. And in here I have to install these, there are those small timing marks in here, very small, one in here and one in here, and I need to set up this my camshaft, and I take a little bit longer this wrench. Okay, I have in here 24 millimeter this wrench, and I rotate in my camshaft. There is this rotation point. Let's look that. First is my small dent, and I can rotate this my camshaft. And then if there is a situation that this cam is not moving, then I need to rotate flywheel, because now it seems that this my cam, these valves takes contact to piston, and that's I need to rotate a little bit flywheel and crankshaft, because pistons are now in bad position. And let's look in here when I little bit rotate my flywheel in that way, and then I can next rotate this my cam in here, because there was situation that valve takes contact to piston. Okay, good. And now this my markings start to came in here, and this mark, that one in here, this is this my marking, and how I can know that there are those, that this is this right position. Even that I have made in here yellow markings before, and then in here we can see this small point. Then we can see in here, there is very small dot in here. And then we know that these are the markings, and then we look in that bearing area also. And here is really this really small arrow in here, that one, and then this area, they must be in same line. And that's I take my tool and a little bit move that, and now these two lines are in same position, and this is intake camshaft. This line and then this dot, and there is the small arrow in here, and then we can also check that there is the small dot in here. Now everything is fine, and in there we can see really 2 millimeter long arrow in here. And now these parts are okay, and I have to use this my tool, look, that one, that we can keep that right position. That's we need now 2 24 millimeter wrench. I need to set up also this exhaust cam, and I need now second wrench, and there is this my small arrow line in here, and then I need to rotate this my camshaft, this sprocket, because there is small dent in here, in that area. And now this line I have already made in here this yellow markings. It helps me now, and there is small dot, and there is this arrow in here, and now they are in same line, and we can also check this arrow in here. Good. And there is really small arrow in here, in that area, and now they are in same line in here. And now both of these camshafts, they are in timing. And now when this both camshafts, they are in position, and remember that I have to adjust that little bit. That is now okay, and then that one is okay. Then I can take this my timing chain, and note that I have two of these my tools in here. Be ready to use both of those, and then I take my timing chain. Then I need to remember to rotate again. This is my crankshaft in this up position. Good. That then it is really important thing. Yeah, now when we can see that this area is line in here, and in that area we have small dent in this area. We have to find in here this small timing mark in here, that dent. It is important. Timing mark. And when all of these are ready, then I can start to install timing chain. Okay, and now when everything is fine, then I can take this my timing chain and note that in up area there must be these two yellow markings in here and one small this yellow marking goes down. And now I install this my chain in here in that way in this area, and then I take this, then I install this first this up area's markings. Up area, this yellow line goes in that area, and then this another one goes in that way, and now these up areas are okay, and then we go to look this down area. Now we are in this down area, and now I have to install this my sprocket, this timing mark to this yellow area in here. Now I install this in here, and then I install this my sprocket back, and then if this is difficult to install, I can adjust this. Now they are ready, and I can a little bit open this sprocket in, this timing chain in up area in that way that I can install this back, and then carefully I keep this timing chain in my hand, and then I install that in back in there. Good. This is like step one, and I check that this dent and this yellow line are okay, and then I can start to go in this up area. And it is good to keep these chains with two fingers, because it can go in that way. But no worry, I install it again back. Good, it is fine. And I keep my fingers in here. Now it's solid, and then we go to look up area. Now we are in up area, and I have to adjust these both timing chains in here, in that way. And look also that this rail in here. Let's go to look rail. The rail must be in this also, in this position, in that way. In that way, good. And then we go back in up. Now, when if this is difficult to install, now I can little bit use my this wrench, and I can little bit carefully move this my timing chain that this chain goes in here, and also that another one, that one, and I have to focus these, and this can take a little bit time when I manage to install those two things in here, and now it is not right. A situation that this line must match in this yellow line. And now when I noticed that I have to somehow move that little bit, now I change this. This my another camshaft, and now I change also. I use my tool and I rotate a little bit that next camshaft in here in that way. Okay, good. And now these markings are fine, excellent. That match and that match also good. And then I have to go to check this down area. Then I have to check that in here everything is fine. And it has moved a little bit, but everything looks okay, good. Everything is. This is quite accurate job, because now these timing chain is okay, and then I can a little bit again move these camshafts, that I can take this more tight, this one, and also another cam. And then I check that good, these are fine, that marking. And then I have to check that these markings are also okay. Yes, they are fine. So that one small dot and that one good, everything fine. And we can go forward. Next step is that there is this chain guide, that part, and small bolt. And this part belongs in here. And they are, and I rotate the 10 millimeter bolt. And this, and it goes very nicely in here. There are dents. Now it's fine, and then I need to use my torch friend's tool in here. Okay, and I need my torch friend's tool, and force is 10 newton meters and 10 millimeter socket. And let's listen sound. Good. And now this guide is in position. And then I install this tensioner slipper. And there is one bolt. And this part below becomes in here. And now when this is a little bit tight, as we can see, I have to rotate this my camshaft. Now I have to rotate a little bit this my camshaft. And there is this my tool. And I carefully, because now this is too much this force. Now this slipper part goes nicely in there, good. And then note that upper area, that this goes inside in here, because now it's badly, it is not in that way. In here, inner area, and I again little bit use my tool and I rotate carefully this camshaft. In back, good. In here, excellent. But now this, I check that there is space to move. And I even even more. Okay, now it's good. Now we can see that this part is fine. And let's go to look that area, because this is critical. Really, when we install the slipper, it must go nicely in here. And I use this my tool and I rotate carefully this in like reverse this camshaft. Okay, now it's fine, because there came tensioner. Okay, this is good. Excellent. And then I need to fasten and tighten the slipper bolt. There is this slipper guide bolt, and I need 14 millimeter socket and torque wrench. Yeah, and there is this my torch wrench tool, and force is now 20 newton meters, what I need, and 12 millimeter socket. And now I fasten that bolt. Good. Now there is enough this force, and now this area is ready. And then I take this sensor plate, and there is this F letter, and it goes in up, in goes in deeper. Good. Now they are nicely. Good. Can see that all parts are well, excellent.